Mission 36 is one of the more unique levels in the HN5 category, with the first visual-based consecutive SK in the route. This quirkiness extends to starting position, which is in the northeast corner of the map. As with Mission 26, note this map orientation when cardinal directions are mentioned. Dash 5 times, then L-jump over the fence. Continue dashing an ungodly amount under the bridge and through the field. Once you reach this bush, turn west and begin crouch walking and rolling through the patrolling ninjas. Once you reach the path, L-jump to grab the fence and climb up. Roll off and land next to the wagon, then strafe forward. Upon a yellow meter, immediately roll in front of the shoji and check the guard to the north. Once he sees you, cycle the sword and roll east-southeast. Roll north into the shadows twice as the north guard walks towards the boss. As the guard passes the building, draw the sword and R-jump into an aerial SK, chaining into a consecutive SK on the boss. While the mash fest that is traversing the field is necessary to catch the guard cycle around the boss, some care needs to be taken with the ninjas patrolling near the fence. Ninjas have greater detection capabilities than regular guards, so a measured approach to the rolls is needed. Rolling too close to the ninjas results in purple meters and possible detections, so giving them a wide berth ensures an unimpeded infiltration of the boss area. The CSK setup is really where the rubber meets the road in this mission. It has both visual and audio components to get the enemies in position, with three key segments. A visual-based CSK can be finicky and difficult to get right. It's a technique in Tenchu Z that you'll need to get a feel for, as it's a strange sequence of inputs that has a narrow margin of error. The strat is mechanically consistent, so practicing the execution and identifying how and why things went wrong are both critical. As with all videos on this channel, feel free to ask questions in the comment section or Discord servers if you're having difficulties replicating the strats. Links, as always, are in the description of the video. Now, let's break down exactly how the CSK works. The first part is the yellow meter on the boss. Strafing is done to allow for a finer granularity in movement, as moving too far forward can result in an outright detection. Staying plainly visible for too long meets a similar fate, so the fire safety doctrine of stop, drop, and roll is fully invoked here. We now have the boss walking southeast, but we need to interrupt his pathing before he emerges from the alley while also getting the attention of the guard to the north. This is where the second segment comes in. The sword draw here overrides the boss's yellow meter state with a purple meter state. If the sword is drawn too early, the boss may not hear it and will continue to walk southeast, resulting in a detection. A drawn sword means higher visibility, so the sword needs to be immediately put away before rolling back into the shadows. Finally, with the boss stationary and the north guard approaching the alley, we can roll into position for the consecutive SK. Wait for the north guard to wander past the edge of the northern building, then draw the sword and R-jump into the aerial SK. The R-jump into aerial synergy is the perfect blend of game mechanics to tie everything together. We'll be placed between the north guard and the boss during the aerial SK, and in close enough proximity for the consecutive SK. Going for the aerial too early can place you too far away from the boss to consistently get the consecutive, so err on the side of caution and slightly delay the final sword draw if there's any uncertainty about enemy positioning.
なんじゃ気のせい。